In our first lesson on discipleship, we showed you that you are now a child of God with all of the privileges of a son available to you since God is now your Father. In this lesson, we're going to show you from the Bible what happened to you spiritually on the inside when you got saved. To understand this lesson, it's important that we start by describing how men were made so that we can understand what happens when we get saved. When God made us, He created us in His image. He says in Genesis chapter 1 and verse 26, let us make man in our image after our likeness. Since God is three persons, He made us with three parts. Now look at Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. The Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. You know what happened? He made us of the dust of the ground, that's our body, and the breath of life, that's our spirit, and He made us a living soul, that's our soul, of course. Our souls match God the Father, our spirits match the Holy Spirit, and our bodies match Jesus Christ. Now notice in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 23 that Paul said, "And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly, and I pray God your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ." Do you see the three parts? There is the spirit, there is the soul, and there is the body. Now, after God made Adam, He commanded him not to eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And He said, "In the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die." That was from Genesis chapter 2, verse 17. Well, you know that Adam ate. And we find that out from Genesis chapter 3 and verse 6. But you know something? When Adam ate that day, he did not die physically that day. Though the Lord said, "In the day that thou eatest thereof, thou shalt surely die." Now notice instead that he lived 800 years after he begat Seth. And he begat Seth after he ate the fruit. We learn that from Genesis chapter 5 and verse 3, where the Bible says, "And Adam lived 130 years and begat a son in his own likeness, after his image, and called his name Seth." Well, if Adam did not die physically until centuries after disobeying God, and yet God said that he would die that day that he ate the fruit, what died? Well, it wasn't his body, and it wasn't his soul. Notice in Matthew chapter 10, verse 28, that Jesus Christ warned his disciples to fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. That's here, right here in Matthew chapter 10 and verse 28. Well, for the body and the souls to be destroyed in hell, they would have to be alive. Therefore, the part that died in Adam had to be a spirit. And since Adam's spirit is the part that died, then all of his offspring become spiritually dead since their spirits die as well. There are a couple of passages that we need to see. Look at Ephesians chapter 2 and verse 1. The Bible says, "And you hath he quickened, who were dead in trespasses and sins." Okay, that shows somebody's alive but dead. Look in Luke chapter 9 and verse 60, and that passage shows you live men that are walking around dead. Jesus said unto prospective disciples, "Let the dead bury their dead, but go thou and preach the kingdom of God." Well, you know what? These are references to men who are physically alive but spiritually dead, just like Adam was. So apparently children are born with a live spirit, but when they sin against God, their spirits die just like Adam's did. To see this more clearly, look with me in Romans chapter 7 at verses 7 through 9. Paul is giving his testimony and he says, "What shall we say then? Is the law sin? God forbid. Nay, I had not known sin but by the law, for I had not known lust except the law had said, Thou shalt not covet. But sin, taking occasion by the commandment, wrought in me all manner of concupiscence," that's just uncontrolled lust, "for without the law sin was dead." Now watch it. "For I was alive without the law once, but when the commandment came, sin revived and I died." Well, you see there, Paul couldn't have died physically. He had to have died spiritually because he was still alive when he wrote this, that he said he died. So, if a child dies before he has the knowledge of the law, you know what's going to happen? He's going to die spiritually safe. We learn this from a few passages of Scripture. First of all, we'll look in Deuteronomy chapter 1. And what we're going to see here is that if a child has no knowledge of the law, he's safe. The Bible says, "Moreover, your little ones, which ye said should be a prey, and your children, which in that day had no knowledge between good and evil, they shall go in thither, and unto them will I give it, and they shall possess it." So they were free to go into the promised land because they had no knowledge of the law. We see again in Romans chapter 4 and verse 15, "Because the law worketh wrath, for where no law is, there is no transgression." And we see in Romans chapter 5 and verse 13, "For until the law, sin was in the world, but sin is not imputed where there is no law." Well, then a child who dies before he has knowledge of the law goes to heaven. Why? Because his spirit hasn't died yet. In Luke chapter 18, verse 16, you remember what happened. Jesus said to his disciples, "Suffer little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God." Well, that takes care of a child before he has knowledge of the law. But if he dies after he has knowledge of the law, and he doesn't get saved, you know what? He's going to go to hell. And that's because he is dead spiritually. You see, once a man's spirit dies, he must be born again in order to have spiritual life. That's why the Lord told Nicodemus, "That which is born of the flesh is flesh," that's his physical birth, that is in the likeness of Adam, "and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit." That's his spiritual birth, to bring his spirit to life again. And then Jesus goes on to say, "Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again." See, that's from John chapter 3, verses 6 and 7. Our spirits were dead before we got saved, and they came to life when we got saved. As you can see from these scriptures, there is absolutely no way that a man will ever have spiritual life apart from a spiritual birth. As he was incapable of giving himself physical life through any action of his own, so he is incapable of giving himself spiritual life through any action of his own, including water baptism, church membership, good works, or anything else you can think of. He can only have spiritual life as a gift of God. Romans chapter 6, verse 23, you probably have memorized, says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." And that spiritual life is given to us by the Spirit of God when we receive Jesus Christ as our Savior. John chapter 1, verse 12 says, "But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God." So you see, when you received Jesus Christ, this is exactly what happened to you. Your spirit came to life after it had been dead, and now you are spiritually alive forevermore. Praise the Lord.